My number one debugging technique exposed. Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. It's rebooting. I'll just get right to it. It's rebooting. It's one of those things where it is such a simple concept, and yet, not only do I use it every day, I find myself recommending it every single day. When in doubt, reboot. I'm kind of surprised at how many people overlook this, because I hate to throw percentages at it, but so many problems are resolved by rebooting your computer, rebooting your mobile device, rebooting your router, rebooting whatever piece of hardware it is that you happen to be having trouble with at the time. I had this happen actually not that long ago. We were watching TV on one of the streaming apps, and all of a sudden it was buffering and it wasn't connecting, and it was having all sorts of problems, making the experience of watching whatever it is we were watching less than ideal, to put it politely. Now, normally, I think a lot of people will end up pausing and unpausing and maybe backing out and backing in and just sort of getting frustrated with the whole scenario. I get that. I do. I will try those potentially. But what I ended up doing was simply using the menu on the device. This was a Roku device. Using the menu on the device to reboot the Roku. And when it came back up, everything was great. Everything was wonderful. We had a fine, fine video experience. Now, I do have to point out that a reboot isn't always what you think. I point out that on this Roku, I went through the menus to actually reboot the system. Again, not reset. Reset loses all your settings. I mean reboot, restart or reboot. The problem is that, especially with devices attached to television sets or potentially even your computer, if you don't actually do a true restart, the hardware may not actually restart. For example, if I turn off my TV, the Roku may still be running. It may still have power applied to it. That's not what I want. That's not a reboot. Turning off the TV is not enough. I need to reboot the device. That's why I use the menu. Same thing is true for your PC or your laptop. Shutting it down by closing the lid and opening it up again? No, that's not a reboot. That's probably just a sleep or a hibernate at best, and both of those two things are very, very different than actually restarting your system. Actually restart your system. Now, the other reboot scenario is similar. I don't do it as often, but it is one of those things that is very much worth understanding and trying before you go much further with whatever problem it is you're trying to resolve. And that is, don't just reboot. Pull the plug. I mean, literally remove the power from the device. And I say that because, again, many devices, you turn them off, they don't really turn off. Or they don't really turn off completely. By unplugging from the mains, disconnecting from the battery, whatever it is you're doing, that forces the device into a completely reset state. Then when you reapply power, it restarts from scratch, and maybe the problem that you've been experiencing will go away. Now, my number two debugging technique, bonus. Wait. I mean that seriously. I have this occasionally with network issues here at home. Something will happen, a site won't connect, an issue will come up, and I'll just beat my head against it for a little while because it's interfering with whatever it is I'm attempting to do, of course. But then I realize, you know what? This is one of those things that actually could be a transient problem. It could be, in my case, it has been, things like my router taking an update and rebooting. Well, okay, yeah, inconvenient timing, but once it's back up, everything's working again. It could be, and has been, a problem upstream with my ISP. They have an equipment failure, or they have a slowdown, or they have something going on. Yeah, I could spend a lot of time contacting their customer service and trying to deal with the issue and maybe get it resolved that way. On the other hand, if it's a big enough issue, it's probably going to get resolved anyway, so wait, do something else. Something else could be using your technology in a different way that doesn't rely on whatever it is that's not working, or it could be walking away from your technology for a while. The bottom line here is that this too is another very valid debugging technique that I think a lot of people overlook because they're so insistent on doing what they want to do right now. Give it a minute, give it a half an hour. Or in the case of, depending on the situation, in the case of my network problems, sometimes I'll just say, okay, fine, you know what? I should stop for the day anyway, and we'll pick it up tomorrow. And sure enough, overnight, everything gets resolved, and the next day is a better day. So the bottom line here is that for many, many different kinds of problems that you might be experiencing with your technology, reboot. It doesn't hurt anything to reboot, and it may very well solve the issue at hand. And if it doesn't, maybe waiting for a little while will. Again, it doesn't harm anything, and it may very well cause you to have a much less frustrating experience when you return. Hope that helps. Like I said, these are absolutely, positively my number one and my number two debugging techniques. Give them a try. For updates, for comments, for links related to this and more, visit askleo.com/153403. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.